Wow, Dada, the clothes are so colorful.
We all love shopping for clothes, don't we? New Zealand itself spends about $4 billion annually on clothes alone. But have we ever wondered how our love affair for clothes affects the developing nations? China, India, Bangladesh, which are the major producers of our clothing, suffer from massive water pollution issues due to textile dye discharge. This has large implications on public health and livelihood. Traditionally, heavy metal catalysts have been used to degrade dyes, but they can release toxic materials themselves. So Nabangshu Sharma, a PhD scholar at the University of Auckland, is trying to tackle this issue in a greener way.
Hi Nabangshu.
Hello.
So could you tell us more about your research?
Yeah, sure. Nature always has a way to self-heal, and enzymes, which are catalysts found in biological systems, play a big role in this. So I'm investigating some enzymes known as lacases from different bacterial species to tackle the issue in hand. These enzymes can catalyze the oxidation of aromatic compounds and hence possesses the potential to degrade dyes as well. I produce and purify these enzymes in our lab here and then check their potency against dyes. I've explored lacases from different extremophilic bacteria to get sequences that are highly resistant to pH and temperature. I've also managed to immobilize them on some solid support to improve their tolerance and increase reusability. This has led me to sequences that are stable over a wide range of pH and temperature. I have then tested them on different industrial dyes, and the early results look quite promising.
So what is your vision for this project?
You know, this is a big issue back home, and my aim is to take my research from my lab to the industrial level and really put it into use in the environment out there. This research holds the potential to solve a major crisis facing us today and restore balance in the environment so that we can keep shopping for heart's content.